Hello students, welcome to the online lecture series of advanced concrete technology. So I was telling you about properties of hardened fiber reinforced concrete. So in that I have covered the first topic, the behavior under compression, means the behavior of fiber reinforced concrete under compression. So this I have covered in last lecture. Now in this lecture the next topic is behavior under tension, means the how the fiber reinforced concrete behaves under tension. When it goes to load, when it goes under load, then how it behaves in tension. Okay, when you are adding fiber to your concrete, then how it behaves in tension. So this is our next topic, behavior under tension. So see, from my notes, see, the direct tension and split tension test are used to determine tensile strength of concrete. So you know now how to test this tension, means we have to make a specimen of concrete, then we have to give load to the concrete through UTM. Okay, then we'll find tension. Okay, so fiber volume fraction of less than 2% do not improve the splitting tensile strength. Okay, and higher strength concrete containing silica fume tends to bond better with fibers, means if you are looking for good tensile strength, then you can add some silica fume to your fiber reinforced concrete to have higher strength. Okay, so the better bond produces fiber fracture rather than fiber pull out. Okay, so if the bond is good in between fiber and matrix, then there will be no possibility of fiber pull out. Okay, so which results in higher splitting tensile strength. So you have to make sure the good bond between fiber and the matrix. So the an increase of up to 200% was reported for lightweight concrete containing silica fume. So silica fume plays an important role when you are adding fibers to your concrete and you are looking for good tensile strength. So you can add silica fume because it improves bond strength. Okay, now in polymeric fiber, means when the fibers having polymers to it, addition of fibers to concrete less than 0.2% of volume fraction does not produce any effect on splitting tensile test. Means if you are adding fiber 0.2% of volume fraction, then it doesn't have any sense. Okay, means it does not improve anything, any tensile strength, any splitting tensile strength. So when the volume fraction of 0.5% or higher, there can be some reduction in strength because of higher concentration of entrapped air. So if you are adding greater than 0.5% or higher, there may be some reduction in strength. So you have to keep the balance between these two things, about 0.2% and 0.5%. So this is behavior under tension, means you have to add silica fume for the good results. Okay, now the next is behavior under flexural and polymeric fibers. See, one more thing for this one, higher fiber volume fraction is needed for high strength concrete to produce concrete failure. Okay, so higher compressive strength always results in brittle mode of failure for both normal weight and lightweight concrete. See this figure. This is increase in strength versus fiber content. If you are increasing fiber content, means it is by percentage by weight. If you are increasing fiber content to your concrete, then how it results in their strength, or how it affects their strength. Okay, so influence of fiber content on tensile strength. So here is the diagram for this. See, on y-axis it is increase in strength and on x-axis fiber content. Okay, so see here, aspect ratio means diameter of the fiber to its length. Okay, so this is aspect ratio, this one, and these are the means if you are increasing fiber content, then of your to your concrete, then ultimate directly it increases the strength too. Means this is a linear relationship between increase in strength and fiber content. So see here, this one and this one. Okay, so here three lines are there. First is black line, blue line and red line. Okay, so here this is the aspect ratio. Black resembles this aspect ratio between 31 to 35. Blue line is for aspect ratio between 63 to 75. And red line is for this one. Means if the aspect ratio is increases. Okay, if aspect ratio is increasing, then their strength goes on down, goes on decreasing. So you have to maintain good aspect ratio. Means you have to maintain aspect ratio between 31 to 35. This is the good one because it gives good strength. Okay, and when you increase aspect ratio, then it then with the increase in fiber content, you cannot get in strength. In desired quantity, in desired ratio, in desired number. Okay, so this is the fundamental of aspect ratio. So see here, see the note. Fiber aligned in the direction of tensile stresses may bring about very large increases in direct tensile strength. Okay, as high as 33% for 5% of smooth straight steel fibers. However, for more or less random distributed fiber, the increase in strength is much smaller, ranging from as little as no increases in the strength. So some instances to perhaps 60%, with many investigation indicating intermediate values as shown. Splitting tensile test of FRC show similar result. Okay, so thus adding fibers merely to increase the direct tensile strength is probably not worthwhile. So some researchers said that, means many researchers, according to many researchers, it has concluded that if you add fibers in randomly order, or rather than uniformly one, then it shows strength in it does not show desired strength. So better to add fiber in a good manner to your concrete. So this is all about behavior of FRC under tension. Now the last one is behavior of FRC under flexural. See, we generally used to test three types, like flexural, compressive and tensile. So compressive and tensile, already completed. Now the next is flexural. Okay, behavior under flexural. So it is the most important aspect for FRC, because flexural test is carried by using 100 by 100 by 350 beam. Okay, so flexural test, generally for flexural test we cast beam, okay, under third point loading. So just remember this one. For FRC we use beam of dimension 100 by 100 by 350 under third point loading. So 3 point loading is there na, so under third point loading of UTM, in UTM. So both fiber volume fraction and aspect ratio plays an important role in bending. Okay, so just when you are dealing with fiber reinforced concrete now, so these two factors, the first one is fiber volume fraction and another one is aspect ratio. These are the two important factors which we have to calculate for every trial. Okay, so longer fibers tend to provide preferred orientation along the length of a specimen, resulting in higher strength increases. Okay, so here they are telling longer fiber is good because it tends to provide preferred orientation, okay, along the length of a specimen. So it directly gives good strength. So for a given fiber geometry, higher aspect ratio results in greater strength increases if the composite is compacted properly. So here three things you have to keep in mind. The first one is volume fraction, okay, fiber volume fraction, and another one is aspect ratio, okay. And the last and the third one, third most important is you have to compact your specimen very carefully, okay. So this is about behavior under flexural, because, and also keep in mind, flexural, for flexural testing we need to cast beam which is of 100 by 100 by 350 under 3-point loading, then only you will get your desired result, okay. So this is all about behavior under flexural. So see the last point, the factor that influence flexural toughness includes fiber type, fiber geometry, fiber volume fraction, matrix composition and specimen size. So these are the factors which influence all the properties of fiber reinforced concrete, whether you are going for compression or tension or anything. So these are the important factor which influences all the properties of your concrete, okay, like fiber length, size, volume fraction and all, okay. So these are the three most important topic of this unit: behavior of fiber reinforced concrete under compression, behavior of fiber reinforced concrete under tension, and behavior of fiber reinforced concrete under flexural. So these are the important one. So now the next topic is steel fiber reinforced concrete, and which we can call SFRC, steel fiber reinforced concrete.